Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about circles and straight lines. Now, a skill I need you really good at is solving simultaneous equations where one of the equations is linear and one is quadratic. So look back at your building blocks for that, otherwise pause the video and make sure you can answer the following question. Okay, you should have got the following. If that makes no sense to you, then you must go back to your building blocks, so you must make sure you know that. Now, another little few skills I need you super good at for this particular video is I want you to pause the video and I want you to recall the general equation of a straight line going through the point 0c, having y-intercept 0c and having a gradient of m. Can you remember how to write the general equation of that line? Well, you should have said that y is equal to mx plus c. So that's what I would have expected. And you must have that absolutely in your head. That's the general equation of a straight line. If you see something written in that form, it's a straight line. Similarly, when you have a straight line, maybe not in that form, sometimes it's useful to convert into this form. All right? Also, do you remember the equation of a circle with center AB, radius r? Pause the video and state that. Well, it looks something like this. X subtract a all squared add y subtract b all squared is equal to the radius all squared there. Okay, for a center AB and a radius r. So you have to be able to remember the equation of the circle too. Okay, now what we're doing in this particular skill. You may have a circle, the red line there, and you may have a straight line, the blue line there, and they may cross over each other. And we want to find the x and y coordinate where they cross here, and the x and y coordinate where they cross here. Maybe I'll call that x2, y2, and I'll call that x1, y1. And we want to find where they cross. So what we're trying to solve is, we've got a linear equation, y equals mx plus c in general, and we've got a circle, which is x subtract a squared add y subtract b all squared is equal to r squared. And we are going to solve these simultaneously to find the x and the y solutions, and that's what we're going to do. And we're going to do it by the technique of substitution that we used at the start of the video to solve a quadratic equation simultaneously with a linear equation. Right, let's start straight away. Find the points of intersection of the circle and straight line given by the equations as follows. So let's try and solve these simultaneously. Let's label that 1 and let's label that 2. This is in the form y equals mx plus c, so we're going to substitute equation 1 for y. In here, we're going to replace y with 2x subtract 2. So let's tell what we're doing. Sub 1 in 2 to get. So don't try and do too much at once. Keep that as x subtract 2 all squared. Add. Now this is going to be 2x subtract 2 subtract 2 all squared is equal to 20. So this here is, we can expand that now. Keep a bracket around it. That's going to be x squared subtract 4x add 4. When we expand that. Now remember this here, if you collect like terms, this is going to be 2x subtract 4 all squared, isn't it? So let's try and expand that in our heads. That would be 4x squared, and that's going to be subtract 16x add 16, and that's going to equal 20. So you must be good at doing these sorts of expansions in your head. It saves you a lot of time. Right, so now we can collect like terms. We've got this bracket, add this bracket, so we can just think of the brackets as not being there. We've got x squared and we've got 4x squared. That's going to give us 5x squared. We've got negative 4x and we've got negative 16x, so that combines to negative 20x. And we've got ourselves here positive 4 and positive 16, which is going to be positive 20. And don't forget, all of that was equal to 20. Now, we've got a 20 on both sides. Let's subtract 20 off both sides in order to solve the quadratic and have one side equaling 0. And we're going to get ourselves that 5x squared subtract 20x is therefore equal to 0. How do we solve these? We factorize. There's a common factor here of 5x. We factor that out and we get 5x, x subtract 4 is equal to 0. And that gives us with two solutions. We either have 5x is 0 or we have x subtract 4 is 0. In this case, x must be 0, and in this case, adding 4 to both sides, x is 4. So I'm just going to do a line over here just to continue my work. You should really go down the page. We've got our solutions for x. We've got that x is 0 is one solution, and we've got that x is 4 is another. We're not done. We're asked to find the points of intersection, so we have to find the x and the y. So to find y here, we're going to substitute x is 0 into the easiest of these, which is clearly 1. So that would be 2 multiplied by 0 take away 0, so y is going to be negative 2. And here, if we substitute in 4, we will get 2 multiplied by 4 take away 2, and y is going to be 6. So at the end, it's nice to state your answer as a pair of coordinates. You can say the solutions are 0, negative 2, and 4, 6, and you're done. Let's try another one. Pause the video and see if you can do this one yourself. Well, let's start by calling that 1 and 2. Now, we're going to do a substitution like we did previously. The only problem is this linear equation is not in the form y equals mx plus c. So let's convert it to that form by subtracting x from both sides and subtracting 5 from both sides to get y is equal to negative x take away 5, and call that equation 3. And that's the one we're going to substitute in here. So let's do that. And what would we get? Well, we have x add 3 all squared, add, and let's substitute in negative x, negative 5, add 5, all squared is 65. Now, when you tidy that up, this bracket is just going to be negative x squared, isn't it? And negative x times negative x is x positive x squared. So we can expand that and expand that in one go. Expanding this, we get x squared, add 6x, add 9. Add what we get when we expand negative x all squared, which is x squared, is equal to 65. Let's combine. Got an x squared there and an x squared there. And why don't I, at the same time, if you don't mind, subtract 65 off both sides, because I know that when I'm solving a quadratic, I must have one side equaling 0. So let's try and do that in one move. X squared and x squared is 2x squared. We've still got add 6x, so write add 6x, but we've got here 9 take away 65 is going to equal negative 56, and this side is now 0. We can divide everything through by 2, because there's a common factor of 2 here, here, and here. And we'd get x squared, add 3x, take away 28 is equal 0. And then we can try and factorise to solve this. So that factorises as x add 7, x subtract 4 equals 0. And that gives us two answers. X plus 7 is equal to 0, or x take away 4 is equal to 0. So x in this case is negative 7, x in this case is positive 4. So let's draw a line and just finish off our work over here. We must find the y values. We know our solutions are x is negative 7 and x is 4. We need to substitute them back into the easiest equation to find y. Well, 1, 2 or 3 is the easiest. In fact, 3 is the easiest. So let's use 3, and we'll say that y is going to be, now it's careful, that's negative. Negative, negative 7, take away 5. Negative, negative 7, take away 5 is 2, so y is 2. And here if we substitute it in, it'll be negative 4 take away 5, which is going to be negative 9. So our solutions are negative 7 and 2 and 4 and negative 9, and we're done. Find the coordinates of the point where the circle crosses the x-axis. Pause the video and have a go. Okay, if you struggle with these, a little sketch will always help you understand what's going on here. Draw yourself an axis and draw yourself a circle there. And think to yourself, where does the circle cross the x-axis? Remember, this is the x-axis here. It crosses it here and here. And that is where the y number is equal to 0. Or you can think of it as intersecting with the line. Remember, that straight line there is the line y equals 0. So when you're crossing with the x-axis, what you're saying is y is equal to 0. So you're solving these two simultaneously, aren't you? So call that 1 and 2, and sub 2 in 1. So what would we get? Let's expand this in one go, and we would get ourselves x squared subtract 2x add 1. And then we got, if we substitute 0 in there, 0 take away 3 is negative 3, all squared is going to be positive 9, and that's equal to 45. Let's subtract 45 off both sides in order to try and solve this quadratic. And we're going to get ourselves that x squared subtract 2x. Now we've got 1 add 9 is 10. Take away 45 is subtract 35 is equal to 0. Factorizing there, you get x subtract 7, x add 5 is equal to 0. So that gives us that therefore x subtract 7 is 0, or x add 5 is 0, and we get x is 7, or x is negative 5. We're not done until we state the y values with that. Should we substitute back in? Well, no, in this case we don't have to. We know that y is equal to 0 at this point. It's where it crosses the x-axis. So our answers are 7, 0 and negative 5, 0, and we're done. Just one thing to point out. Imagine instead if it said where it crosses the y-axis. Where it crosses the y-axis would be where x is 0, and you would be solving two simultaneous equations, a circle and the line x is 0, and doing the same thing, similar thing here, and getting an answer in a similar way. That's it for this particular video. Thanks loads for watching.